Hi, Jay here. Today we're going to be talking about designing for print and using Photoshop. So, quickly before, I'm going to explain something shortly. So, I designed a banner for a client of mine. The original dimension of that banner was 9 feet by 5 feet tall, which is equivalent to 108 inches by, I think, about 60 inches. Alright? So, of course, the way I work with my clients, I have to send them a preview before I send them the print file because I would not have want to have to send a very large file many times. So I sent the preview version at this dimension in pixels, definitely 1944 pixels by 108 pixels. So, and here's what I'm trying to tell you. My client forgot to get back to me that there was no correction and I could go ahead with the print file. He went ahead and printed this particular dimension in pixels, 1944 by 1080 pixels. I happened to see the banner by surprise in my area that particular day. And I was shocked, but at the same time I was surprised because I never expected that the banner would come out that good. If not that I was the designer who designed it, I couldn't have detected that it was a low quality file that we used to print this banner. Now let's calculate the GPI of this banner if that's what he printed it as. Now that is, we're going to divide the respective pixel by the respective inches. So that's 1944. Okay, 1944 divided by 108. What does that tell us? It tells us that that banner was printed at 18 dpi. So what I found out was that if a banner could do well at 18 dpi, why do I then have to stress my machine using the standard of 300 dpi? Ever since then, things changed. Whenever I wanted to design for a very large format print, I made it of CorelDRAW, or probably I designed. I try not to do much large size print design. That was just the two things I was doing there. But when I found this out that my banner could still survive at this very, very, very low, that's less than 10% of the standard required resolution. Understand? So ever since then, I told myself that let me try this thing out and see how it works. I never used 18 dpi again. I also make sure that whenever I'm sending my preview files to my clients, I tell them that this is not for print. Right? I decided to test using values within 100 dpi. And 150 dpi. That way, with that, I could handle designs as large as 20 feet by 10 feet all in Photoshop. And I send them at this resolution, I don't come up with a crazy file size. At the same time, we still come out with a very good quality print. However, when we are dealing with small print size, like probably 5 inch by 7 inch, there's something in the range of 8.5, 8.4, 8.3, anything that's still very much less than 4 feet by 4 feet. I would advise you stay at 300 dpi. Whenever I'm doing something that small, I never go less than that. So I got to understand that each machine has its actually required, or it has its limits. Right, it has its limit. 300 is like the standard everywhere, but some of these machines don't necessarily need 300. I got to understand that there's a machine that print fine dots. If you were to be scientific about it, here you could actually see that it prints around 300 dots per inch, dead truly. But if you look at this large format print, some of them you can actually see the dots that they printed. There are some machines you can't find the dots. The eyes are not that magnificent to see those tiny things. You understand? So if you actually want to be scientific about it, you see that some of these machines don't need a whole 300 dpi to print good quality print, because even when they are printing, they don't print at 300 dpi. I also found out that some of these printers, not all works are sent at 300 dpi to the large format printer. I was able to find out that sometimes they drop it down to 150, sometimes they drop it down to 100, especially if they are dealing with a very, very large banner, so that the machine will not run into problems. So finding that out, it changed everything I was doing. Whenever I'm designing for large format printing, I stay within 100 to 150 dpi. And whenever I'm designing for something smaller, I stay with the 300 dpi standard. Alright? So that's just the value. These are just the values I work with. For large print, anything greater than 4 by 4 feet. Then this one, I use this for small sized print design. Anything less than 4 by 4 feet. Alright, so this is what I've been using, and so far I've not received any problem. You can test it out and see if it works for you as well. I'm not saying that this is something that is recognized worldwide, but this is what I've gotten from my own experience. So let me now hint you how I actually do my designs inside of Photoshop. Now, since I know, let's say I'm preparing a print file for an A5 document, let's say 5x7 for example. I do it this way. Okay, so I make sure that, now there are two ways you can do this. You actually either create your color mode in CMYK first. That's the first method. The second method is you design everything in RGB, then you convert it to CMYK. But it's not a direct method, okay? So, but let's just follow through this one. Make sure that your color mode is in CMYK. Remember, we're using 5 inch by 7 inch, then at 300 DPI, that's the resolution. Basically, just maybe pixel per inch. It's almost equivalent. It's equivalent, but they don't mean the same thing. It's equivalent. All right, don't use pixel per centimeter. So from there, you just create. Now, I will not advise you to start your design here in CMYK because there are a lot of things that will limit you. For example, you cannot use a lot of effects. You can't use exposure in case you are designing something that will require some lightning and everything. You can't use exposure, you can't use vibrance, you can't use some of these filters. And some things also are grayed out that you can't use. You can't use a lot of things. Right? You can't use a lot of things in the same like spectrum. Okay? So what I do is, what I learned to do from a course I bought is that you convert the layer, one of the layers, probably just like to this main design. Okay, let me just title that main design. Just right click, convert it to a smart object so that you create another more like creating another document within this document. So when you click it, you go into a new document. This is where you do your design. But instead, remember this is also still as CMYK. The first one we're going to see, this first one is as CMYK. But this internal document that we're creating as a smart object, you're going to convert it to an RGB color spectrum so that you're going to make your design here. So once you're done with your design and you save, it converts it straight to CMYK for you. Alright? In like the nearest possible and the best possible way. Without having to give you complications. So like I said, we're designing RGB in this spectrum, in this document, it saves as a smart object in the original document. Alright? So let's go back and change it to the RGB color thing. Now you go to this edit. What people do is they come to mode, and this is actually not a good way to do it. Come down to convert to profile. It automatically selects RGB since that's not the previous, that's not the color mode there, right? So it just selects for you. So RGB from here. Okay, so everything is there. So what you just have to do is to make your design. For example, let me see if I can just find one, not necessarily my design, but any design really. Okay, let me just have this. Okay, this is not my design. Okay, this is just one of the images I've used to my moodboard. Okay, let's say this is our design, right? Let's say this is our design. You save, of course, remember to turn this layer off because you really don't need it. Except if it's not disturbing you, but if it's disturbing you, turn it off. So let's say I've saved this, I'm done with my, this is my design. So what needs to happen now is I just go to the next, the main layer, this is the design, but in this case, it's in CMYK. Here, it's in RGB, okay? It's in RGB. Let me just put it here. Let me rename this one. In RGB here, and here it's in CMYK. Okay, let's assume we are done with our design. We save it, everything of this here. So it's time for you to export it. Now, I'm going to show you how to export this in JPG and PDF. I want to ask you to export your print file in PNG because, from what I've noticed, most of the time PNG files are for digital screens only. It only exists most of the time, it only exists in the RGB color spectrum. So you cannot use RGB for print. So definitely, I don't expect you to export your print file in PNG. So you just have to come to file, save as. Okay, let's say I'm going to save this in my desktop now. Okay, yeah, let me just click. Let me select JPG first, okay? Alright, uncheck this, please uncheck this, uncheck this. Okay, then you just save basically. Maximum, basically, you have the largest file possible. That's it. Now, because these are color spectrums, they're already in CMYK, so we don't have more stress, more process to go through. Then let's say again as PDF. Now, this time, PDF. Okay? Now, uncheck the layers because one, you have to understand that your client, so your printer doesn't need the editable Photoshop file. It basically doesn't need it. All right. So uncheck the layers so that it's going to be flattened. Okay. Uncheck this the same way we did for the previous, for saving as JPG. Uncheck this, but instead check this one. All right. This is the color you wanted to use, not this one. Okay. Not white content. Okay. So once that is done, once you have uncheck layer, yeah, save as copy, blah, blah. Then, you want to select high quality print, but always make sure you uncheck Photoshop editing capabilities, because what this means is that it takes in some Photoshop capabilities into the PDF, so it makes the PDF a lot larger. Alright, so you don't want that. You don't need it to be editable again by Photoshop, because what that means is that it's going to be editable again by Photoshop. Ensure that this is at these values. That's compression JPG, or I use JPG most of the time. Image quality, I advise you to stick between maximum and high. Okay, so basically that's all. Then you just save PDF and wait for it to render. I think that is done. So now we are going to view our designs for Xbox. Now you're going to notice two things. Whenever you're exporting a JPG file for print, don't expect the colors to come out exactly as it looked when it was in RGB. No. Most of the time it's going to be changed. You will think that something is wrong, but no, nothing is wrong. That's because the image is in CMYK and your screen is in RGB. An RGB display will not read the CMYK color well enough. The only reason why Photoshop can read the colors for you here is because Photoshop has already done that conversion for you so that you can work with the original colors that are in the image. Alright? But when you're sending for print your screen, when you're viewing the final file, your screen doesn't do the conversion for you. Your screen shows you that this image is actually in CMYK and this is supposed to be a print file. Okay, that's what it tells you. This is what you now send to your printer. You can import it into any print application it's using. let's say for the corridor, for example, if you import this corridor, we'll definitely read this image as the CMYK image. That's that for the JPG version. But you can see the size about almost 2 megabytes. This one is about 2-3 megabytes. So the thing about PDF, the PDF version is that the PDF version will never show you the CMYK preview. Okay, it will show you like it's in algebraic, but definitely it's CMYK. The only way you can know that it's CMYK is because you are sure you exported it as CMYK. Alright, so those are just the two possible formats that I use for exporting my print files. So I hope you learned something from today. So I think from today you should not stress your laptop too much. Remember, for large file size, you want to stay within this range. For small prints, you want to stay at the standard. Alright, so thanks for joining me today. Take care of yourself. Bye.